It works.
So this is Call of Duty Modern Warfare.
This is Warzone. Watch the skies.
And you're connected using Starlink satellite internet.
Yep. Out here at the park.
Out here at a park with no service on my cell phone.
And it runs great.
Few moments later.
We've been booted out a few times.
That was a little bit disappointing.
No service.
Boom.
The lights are on, which is a good sign.
Starlink, we're gonna press on that.
And now we're connecting in a spot that's totally open. So it should just take a moment here.
Much, much, much later.
You moved. It's alive. So as you can see right now, the Starlink is set up in a place with completely clear sky, no obstructions. And I want to show you something kind of interesting about it. Let's take our infrared thermometer here. As you can see, it's sitting at about 64 degrees. And so basically I'm just showing you this because this unit works fine in rain or snow. It has the capability to heat itself up. So why don't I go to, I don't know where to go, my website. Hey, okay, so that's pretty cool. Let's go to YouTube.
Adversity brings opportunity and really, I think what you do with
so,
the opportunity is-
it works well enough to play a YouTube video. That is a good sign. Which, by the way, you should subscribe.
How are you doing? Doing well. How are you?
Good.
It works. So this is Call of Duty Modern Warfare.
Tried to play that game and it kept failing, so honest review here, that was frustrating, but we're gonna try to stream a 4K video on YouTube and see how that works. See, it's been playing YouTube videos just fine. Let's get this ad here and make sure that this is in 4K, not 360p. Let's see if you can do it. So, here it is, streaming a 4K video on YouTube without any hitches, but unfortunately, well, yeah, trying to play that game was just not working out for us. So, Starlink seems to be a bit spotty if you want to play a game, but it hasn't really been giving us trouble with accessing YouTube, playing videos. I kind of wonder how it would do uploading a video. So I'm downloading a clip from my Google Drive, which I was able to access. And once that downloads, I'm going to upload it onto YouTube just to prove that we can. Because today is all about testing things out, what works, what doesn't work. So we just uploaded this short clip, and as you can see, it's the one that I set to private. This is just the random clip that I pulled from an interview. So this took less than 10 minutes to download a random clip from my Google Drive and then upload it onto YouTube, which is pretty good. That definitely boosted Starlink's rating in my mind, but is it worth the money? Well, it's $499 for the phased array antenna and the router, and then you're looking at a $99 per month subscription, so
I think it's not quite there yet to be paying that kind of money, but it's getting really close. And as time goes on, it's going to improve even more with more satellites in orbit. Right now, there are just a little over 1,000 Starlink satellites in orbit, but the goal is to eventually have a constellation of 42,000 satellites. One of the things that I didn't realize would be a factor here in getting our connection is not just having a clear sky and no obstructions, but it's actually dependent on if a satellite is overhead. So as you can see, this was kind of what we went through for the last hour or so. It definitely was not consistent with the connection. So you can see that there were periods where there was a spike and the connection would be really, really good, over 50 megabits per second, and then all of a sudden, no connection. So that's really frustrating. So sometimes, yes, it was pretty decent speed, but that's all dependent on if a satellite is orbiting overhead. Beta downtime, 10 minutes. So I guess it was only 10 minutes overall, and we've been out here doing this for about an hour. But you know, if you're gonna try and play a game, for example, well, we couldn't even log on to the game, but we could do other things like upload a YouTube video out here, which is pretty amazing considering I have no cell phone service out here. So one of the reasons that Starlink is much faster depending on where the satellites are is because it's operating at a low Earth orbit. So it's 340 miles away. Compare that to the geostationary orbit of traditional satellite internet, 22,000 miles away. So a lot closer, but as we have discovered here today, it all depends on if there's a satellite overhead, and that can make the connection spotty. But over time, this will improve. So Starlink is targeting 50 to 150 megabits per second in this public beta, and it's expected to definitely only get faster from there. Starlink is continuing to make headlines. Look at this article from just 2 days ago. It plans to add a phone service, emergency backup, and low income access. In the future, Starlink is projected to have speeds of 10 gigabits per second. That's about 100 times faster than the average wired internet connection. Super lightning fast. So that's really exciting and definitely something to look forward to.